Today, I'm going to be going over all the extrude options you have in Blender while you're modeling. We covered the basics of extruding, so let's have a quick recap. So I'll press Shift A, and under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube to add the cube into my scene, and then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode. To go into Face Select Mode, I'm going to press 3 on the keyboard, and that means when I left click, I can select one of my faces. Last time we learned that if we press E on the keyboard, we can extrude a face or a vertex or an edge out like this. It also works with a collection of faces, vertices, or edges as well. When you're happy with your extrusion, you can just press left click to save it. If I come to my Edit Mode toolbar here, you can see here we have an option called Extrude Region. If I left click this, you can see a little gizmo will appear, and when I hold down the plus with left click and pull, you can see it's going to work just like the E key on the keyboard. As I mentioned in previous tutorials, I usually like to use shortcuts or hotkeys instead of the toolbar, as it's a lot faster and more intuitive for me. If I hold down this extrude region box, you can see we have a bunch of options, which we're going to be covering today. You can also access these with a hotkey. If I left click the select box, go back to default, I can press Alt E, and that's going to open the extrude menu. And here you can see we've got all of those options we had. For now, I'm going to press Ctrl Z until I have just my default cube again, and then I'm going to press A, and I'm then going to right click and choose Subdivide. I'm going to be going over the Subdivide tool more in depth in the next video, but for now, I'm just going to open up this Subdivide box and increase my number of cuts to something like 2. Then I'm going to left click one of my faces here, and I'm going to press Alt E, and this time I'm going to choose Extrude Manifold. You can see when I pull out a face here that it hasn't left behind some edges like you would usually get when extruding. Also, if I pull it back, you can see that it's not going to go inward like with a normal extrusion. I'm going to compare the two just now. So I'll left click to save it here, and then I'm going to choose the face on this side here, and just press E, which is a normal extrusion. Notice how when I bring it out, there's still edges here, and when I pull it inward, you can see that it's going to preserve the faces here as well. So Extrude Manifold is great to avoid this kind of issue here. You notice if I press 1 to go into Vertex Select Mode, that's also created some more vertices here for us. And if I press 3 on the keyboard, select this face, and then press 1 on the keyboard to go into Vertex Select, press Alt E, and then choose Extrude Manifold again. When I pull out my manifold, you can see that it's going to create what we call an N-gon, which is a face with over 4 vertices. I'm going to be talking about the 3 types of faces, tries, N-gons, and quads in a later video in this series, as it's quite an important topic. I'm going to press Ctrl Z and just undo all of my changes. This time I'm going to left click this face here, and I'm going to shift left click a few random faces which I want to extrude at the same time. Now I'm going to press Alt E, and this time I'm going to choose extrude faces along normals. When I left click this, you can see when I move my mouse, I can extrude multiple faces at the same time. And while it's working fine for these extrusions here, you can see the ones which share a vertice have some issues. To better demonstrate what's happening, I'm going to press Ctrl Z to undo, then I'm going to press A to select everything. Now when I press Alt E and choose extrude faces along normals, you can see that's going to keep everything connected together like this. This may be fine for some purposes, but if you just want to extrude all of your faces out at once, like I've shown on the thumbnail here, this might not be what you're looking for. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo, and instead what we can do is press Alt E and choose Extrude Individual Faces. Now you'll notice it's going to bring out all the faces and there won't be any connections. There is a bit of a caveat to this though, and that's that if I left click one of my faces here and press G to move it, you can see that this face isn't attached to the faces beside it. However, fixing this is super easy. All I would need to do is just press A to select everything, and if you remember in a previous tutorial, we can use the merge tool. So I'll press M on the keyboard to open the merge menu, and we can just choose by distance. If I open up this merge by distance menu, you can see it's going to choose a really, really small number. Keep it at this because this small number will pretty much make it so only the vertices that are overlapping each other will be merged together. And that'll prevent us from merging anything together that we don't want to merge. Now when I left click one of my faces and press G, you can see it's now connected. I'll right click to cancel my movement, and now I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to undo all my changes again. The next tool I want to cover is the Extrude to Cursor tool. So I'll left click a face, and this isn't going to extrude to our 3D cursor, but rather it refers to the mouse cursor. So to do this is really simple. All you do is hold down Ctrl and then right click, and you can see it's going to pull out my face like that, and I can just keep doing it, and I can create some easy extrusions that way. Also, if I left click this face here and come down to my extrude region tool in the toolbar, left click and hold and change to extrude to cursor. Now all I need to do is just left click with this tool, and you can see it's going to create some very easy extrusions. Press Ctrl Z to undo all of those changes. I can also press 1 on the keyboard, go into vertex select mode, and I'm going to left click my select box again and left click one of my vertices. And I can of course press Ctrl right click with this as well to make some extrusions that way. And you can do this with edges too. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo all of that. I'm going to press 1 on the keyboard to make sure I'm in vertex select mode still. And when I press Alt E, you're going to notice that that we have a couple more options, that being Extrude Edges and Extrude Vertices. Extrude Edges, if I left click it, and then I'll press S to scale, you can see that it's extruded out just the edges and it's ignored the faces. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo those changes, and I'll press A again, and this time when I press Alt E, I'm going to choose Extrude Vertices. Now when I press S, you can see it's just going to pull out some vertices. So that's a cool way to get a little bit more control over your extrusions. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. This time I'm going to press Alt E, and I'm going to choose Extrude Repeat. Right now, if I open up this Extrude Repeat menu in the bottom left hand corner here, you can see we've got a few options, and it's actually created a bunch of extrusions in a direction. If you've ever used the Array modifier before, Extrude Repeat works in a very similar manner. To start off, you can see we've got something called an offset, and this determines what direction the Extrude Repeat will go in. So I'm going to left click and then quickly drag down. You can see that's going to highlight all of my offset axes here. I'm just going to type in the number 0. That's just going to keep it at the default. And I just want to move it across this green line here. So the only one we need to worry about is the y-axis. So I'll left click the arrow here, and you can see it's going to push it inward. And that means we just need to do it the other way. So I'll left click the other arrow instead and start moving it out. You can see we've got a bunch of extrusions being pulled out, and the number of extrusions we have is determined by the steps here. So I could change it to a lower number, and then I can decrease my y-axis in this case. And you can see that way we can create a bunch of extrusions in a row. You can also further adjust our offset by using the scale offset parameter. And when I increase this, you can see it's just going to increase everything. And yeah, that just about covers all the tools you need to know for extruding in Blender. If you did enjoy this tutorial, feel free to check out the playlist here where I cover a bunch of different techniques you need for modeling in Blender. It starts from an absolute beginner level, so if you're new to Blender, it can be very useful for you. There'll also be more videos being added to it daily. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.